वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स स्टैंडर्ड 8th. 12. इक्वेशन इन वन वेरिएबल. पॉइंट नंबर 1. एन इक्वेशन विच इज वन वेरिएबल इज यूज्ड इज नोन एज इक्वेशन इन वन वेरिएबल. पॉइंट नंबर 2. द वैल्यू ऑफ द वेरिएबल विच सैटिस्फाइज द गिवन इक्वेशन इज कॉल्ड द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ द इक्वेशन. एग्जाम्पल, सॉल्विंग द इक्वेशन 9x माइनस 4 इज इक्वल टू 6x प्लस 29. नाउ सॉल्यूशन, एडिंग टू 4 बोथ साइड्स. सो 9x माइनस 4 प्लस 4 इज इक्वल टू 6x प्लस 29 प्लस 4. देयरफॉर minus 4 plus 4 will cancel, therefore 9x is equal to 6x plus 29 plus 4 become 33. Subtracting 6x from both sides, 9x minus 6 is equal to 6x plus 33 minus 6x, so 3x is equal to 33. Dividing both sides by 3, 3x upon 3 is equal to 33 upon 3, therefore x is equal to 11 is the answer. 13. Concurrence of triangle. Point number 1. The figure which exactly coincide with each other are called concurrent figures. Point number 2. The symbol is used to show concurrence. The sum of the measure of an angle of a triangle is 180 degree. Test for concurrency of triangles. Number 1. SAS test. If two sides and included angles of a triangle are congruent with two corresponding sides and the included angle of the other triangle, then the triangles are congruent with each other. Look at the figure. In triangle ABC and triangle LMN, length of AB is equal to length of LM. Length of BC is equal to length of MN. Measurement of angle ABC is equal to measurement of angle LMN. Therefore, triangle ABC is concurrent to triangle LMN. Therefore, it is a SAS test. SAS test. If three sides of a triangle are concurrent with three corresponding sides of the other triangle, then the two triangles are concurrent. Look at the figure. In triangle PQR and triangle XYZ, length of PQ is equal to length of XY. Length of QR is equal to length of YZ. Length of RP is equal to length of ZX. Therefore, triangle PQR is congruent to triangle XYZ. It is a SSS test. ASA test. If two angles of a triangle and a side included by them are congruent with two corresponding angles and the side included by them of the other angle, then the triangles are congruent with each other. In triangle XYZ and triangle DEF, length of XZ is equal to length of DF. Angle X is congruent to angle D and angle Z is congruent to angle F and angle XYZ is congruent to angle triangle DEF. It is a ASA test. Number 4. AAS test, that means angle-angle side test. If two angles of a triangle and a side not included by them are congruent with corresponding angles and a corresponding side not included by them of the other triangles, then the triangles are congruent with each other. In triangle ABC and triangle DEF, length of BC is equal to length of EF. Angle A is congruent to angle D. Angle B is congruent to angle E, then triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. It is a AAS test. Number 5. Hypotenuse side test. If the hypotenuse and the side of a triangle are congruent with the hypotenuse and the corresponding side of the other triangle, then the two triangles are congruent with each other. In triangle ABC and triangle LMN, angle B is equal to angle M is equal to 90 degree because it is a right angle triangle. Hypotenuse AC is congruent to hypotenuse LM. Therefore, length of AB is equal to length of LM. Therefore, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle LMN. It is a hypotenuse side test. Thank you.